You're now tuned into the Not Your Average Podcast. But yes, you did. Episode number 28. We in the building. TNT Tez, let's go. I go to the strip club, I'm having ones like done. She eat the meat, no bun. Yeah, she eat the meat, no bun like sesame. I'm in the streets like sesame. Big TNT, roll woods like Cherokee. Smoke dope, glitz look just like Jeremy. Fuck that, Gav look just like Lynn. I'm having drip like Shark Boy, grow me a fan. I have a show, might fuck me a fan. Spin back the back like a fan. Spin back the back like hood. Pop the R car like the engine, got took out the hood. He was sitting in the front, had to put his brain right in the back seat. Too many hoes need a stat sheet. Ruthless, put her on the block list. Soon as she at me, come on her face like acne. Bro selling white boy, Conor McGregor. She wanna fuck me, double G letter. I met a pack like a letter. TNT stand by myself like a letter. I'm going up like a ladder. She ride the dick too wild, she might need a saddle. Big drip might need a paddle. Can't fuck with a snitch nigga, I know he gon' tell like tattle. Feel like a daughter's bitch giving me tail. She grip the dick like a whale. Me and I slam a nigga out like
forgot that thing existed.
Hammer time, I'm in no walls like nails. You win and got put in the ER. Trying to get rich like Roddy. Eat her, fuck make the bed, say eat her. Eat up the dick, on God ain't eat her.
Water?
I like how this beat say woo woo.
Need some more water?
Walk in the spot, dead bitches say who you. Stayed on the op block, no new. I'm in New Orleans, this cute bitch showing me voodoo. And I like how the beat say wee hoo. I got 100 hoes, trick who, fuck up, won't get a redo. Fuck 12, I'm screaming free hood today, free you. She suck the dick, spit, sit on my stomach. I'm coming up like vomit. Act like a bitch, then I'm on this top like buttons. No Easter, I nut on the thick snow bunny. No hard feelings, I nut on the thick bitch mama. Me and Chad like dumb and G. She eat the dick, no teeth, she a gummer. Give a fuck about your folks,
I'm not gonna lie, I hear like every other word.
He's rapping, rapping.
Yeah. What's that song from? Is that like a Gwen Stefani song?
Yeah, I'll play it here. First and foremost, you guys are now officially tuned into episode number 28 of the Not Your Average Podcast.
Yes, it is Monday.
It is Monday. After the Super Bowl, the Chiefs have won.
Yes, they did, dude. I almost wore my Chiefs hat.
I got a free haircut from our barber.
Dude, I totally forgot about that.
Yeah, bro, free haircut from Marco the barber. For the Chiefs winning.
$100 worth.
Yeah, I don't have to pay $100 for a haircut.
That's a lot.
Yeah, so pretty excited about that.
I get it.
To answer your question, that is a Gwen Stefani song.
Yeah, I can't remember the name of it. But
is it Sweet Escape?
One. Yes.
Escape.
Oh, it is.
Gwen Stefani.
Let's see.
Oh, the YouTube ads.
Gotta love them.
Gotta love them. All right,
just,
here we go.
They're just everywhere. Oh, here we go.
Yeah, it's the same sample.
It's just sped up.
Yeah. Is it? Was it sped up? Yeah, it's sped up. People haven't heard. Oh, Akon was in it?
Yeah, I think so.
Really?
Yeah.
She was like rapping fast in this, dude.
Cause I've been acting like sour milk all on the floor. It's your fault, she didn't shut the refrigerator. Maybe that's the reason I've been acting so cold.
Damn.
If I could escape and recreate a place in my own world, and I could be your favorite girl forever, perfectly together. And tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet? If I could be sweet.
Anyway, yeah, that's the sample that TNT Tez used on that song, the intro song.
You should fast forward to Akon. I kind of want to hear what he says.
Dude, I don't remember Akon being in this song, which is kind of crazy.
I kind of can.
Let's see.
Is that all he says? Doing the thing?
Is that the only thing he says? That's all he says.
Never mind.
That's enough of that, bro.
Yeah, he got a feature.
He got a feature. He probably got paid like $100,000 to do that feature, though.
I'd do it.
Just
sit there and go, wee-hoo!
Yeah, for sure, bro. So, yeah, Chiefs have won, guys.
Yes, sir.
Super Bowl champs. How
we're
cool.
We're both Chiefs fans, if nobody knew that.
If you guys didn't know that, we're huge Chiefs fans.
Flaunt it all the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, no.
Like, we're not
no, no,
just
no.
Like,
the people, ugh. The people that know us know that we're Chiefs fans.
And I don't care that much. Like, if they lost, I wouldn't lose sleep.
No, I really wouldn't. But that's the team that I go for.
Yeah, for sure.
You know
that's
what
the
I'm
team
saying?
I'm cheering for. Exactly.
Like, I'm not going to, like, be sad. It's just a game to me. I don't really care.
Exactly.
What
did you think about it, man?
Dude, it was really good.
It was pretty good. I thought it was a good game all around.
It was really good. Jalen Hurts came out and was like, he was gunning for that, dude. He was trying to win it.
Yeah, for sure. But there was also like Pacheco on the Chiefs, man.
Dude, Pacheco.
He was running with some heart.
Pacheco coming out of Rutgers. He's from New Jersey.
Yeah, rookie.
Mm-hmm. Rookie yeah. year. Killed it, dude. He actually, he replaced Clyde Edwards, which came from, he came from LSU.
Oh, he replaced Clyde Edwards?
Yeah. Clyde Edwards was a running back for us for the last 2 years, I think.
I thought he replaced Tyreek Hill.
No. Tyreek Hill wasn't a running back. Tyreek Hill was a receiver.
Yeah, but they kind of played the same type of position, though. Like, Tyreek Hill kind of would, like, get the ball every once in a while, hand it off.
Yeah,
and
I guess.
And they threw to that guy. Like, I get what you're saying, though. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I feel
definitely
like
right.
Pacheco was more of a running back,
as, like,
though.
Position goes. That's yeah. What, yeah.
He was recruited to be a running back at college at Rutgers, and then I think they picked him up as a running back
yeah.
for the Chiefs. But, bro, I don't think they'll ever be able to replace Tyreek Hill.
No.
I don't think they need him, though.
No, I think
this,
they got
this kind of proves it. Like, you can have all you need is somebody to be able to catch the ball.
Yeah, facts.
And run.
Yeah.
And you're good.
And
Tyreek just added to it.
Yeah. He added an extra dynamic because he was almost the exact opposite of Travis Kelce.
Exactly.
Travis Kelce was like slower, like big guy.
Run 5 yards and cut.
Taller than you.
Yeah.
Tyreek Hill was this guy that was going to outrun you.
And go long. And you knew he was going to catch it. Most of the time.
Yeah. We were pretty sure.
Yeah.
Just like we knew that they were going to hit that field goal.
Fuck.
Dude.
I saw that happen and I was like, we're fucked.
I know.
We're so fucked.
I was like, that's going to screw us in the end.
Yeah, no, but dude, they pulled through.
Yeah.
Big Red got his win, man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so that was a huge thing.
What do you think about the halftime, dude?
Miss Rihanna?
Yeah.
I fuck with Rihanna, bro.
That was actually really good. Have you even seen all the stuff online about she was pregnant?
Yeah, bro. She's pregnant as fuck.
Yeah. I didn't notice it until like halfway through.
Laura noticed it right away.
Right away. She was on it.
Yeah, she's like, oh my God, she's pregnant. Yeah, she knew right away.
Also, shout out Snood.
Shout out Snood.
You haven't done that in a minute.
He has downloaded remember from the beginning of this podcast, everybody that's been listening and watching, we always try to shout out Chris and we always try to shout out Snood.
Yep.
Snood recently told Garrett that he downloaded all our episodes.
So we'll
update you guys when he finally has heard his shout out.
Yep.
But Chris hears his name all the time. But shout out to Chris, shout out to Snood.
Yes.
Dude, I forgot how many like bops Rihanna kind of had.
I know too. She was going through them just one after another. And I'm like, oh man.
Yeah, dude. What, if you had to pick a Rihanna song, what would be your favorite Rihanna song?
Oh man, it's that one that like
and like nobody can say anything about you, and you're just in your car by yourself blaring it.
It's singing. Like, it's a good walkout song.
Good walkout song.
Yeah. Oh, what is it?
Is it an umbrella?
All of the lights.
Oh, she sings on the Kanye West song. Yeah. All of the lights.
That one's really good. I like that.
Let's see if we can pull that thing up. You know.
Yo.
You heard me? Let's see. This video is giving us a warning that has been identified to give people epilepsy.
Yikes, dude.
So if you can get absolute epilepsy by hearing, don't listen.
You said that by hearing, don't listen.
Yeah, but it's only a visual thing.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying about too. The intros on the videos?
Yeah.
They always add like another extra 30 seconds to the video.
Some of them I like it.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
Some of them I don't.
What is this? Is this a violin? Or
yeah,
one
I
of
think
those big
so.
Ones?
No, I think it's a... I actually don't know. I shouldn't say. I was going to act like I knew. Dang, this is a long
intro. It's a long ass intro.
How long is this? Dang.
It's a minute.
Start. Come on. All
of the lights. This one?
Yeah, this one just gets me going, dude. Especially at the Super Bowl.
Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn the lights in here, baby. getting a little carried away.
Yeah, I like this one. What about you, man?
Bro, I don't know, dude. I kind of like when she raps.
Oh, okay.
What's that one called? I think it's called Strip Club. It's not what it's called, but it's like Strip Clubs and Dollar Bills. Still got my money. What's that called? You know what I'm talking about, bro.
Yeah.
What is that called? Strip Clubs and Dollar Bills. Still got my money. What is it? Oh, Pour It Up. That's what it is. Pour it up.
Watch it all fall out.
Start Whatever. By talking they can get to your the little 2 seconds of fucking is right for you.
Revenant.
Whether you and your doctor just
let's go. This one, yeah. Mike Will made it. Damn, son, where'd you find this? I can't make that noise. Watch it all fall out. Pour it up. Okay, Rihanna. Watch it all fall out. Clubs and dollar bills. So got my money. Patron shots, gonna get a refill. Love that beat. So got my money. Strippers gone up and down that pole. So got my money. 4 o'clock and we ain't going home. So got my money. Money make the world go round. So got my money. Fans make your girl go down. Still got my money. Fly more where that came from. So got my money.
I love this part too coming out. Yeah, she's like, oh.
All I see is dollar signs. Hey, I see why ASAP Rocky's got her pregnant for the second time. God damn.
Oh, it was him?
Yeah.
I didn't know who it was.
Yeah. Fall out from the sky.
Throw it up.
Anyway, that's the one I like, dude. I really fuck with that one. I fuck with that one. I also mess with like the old stuff, dude. I work with Drake.
Yeah, that was a good one too.
They used to play this shit at the bars.
They're all kind of bops.
All the time. Work. You send me heavy work. You see me do me dirt. You see what I'm saying though? I can't blame Rocky.
Work.
Two kids, man.
She did that for Super Bowl.
Yeah, did she?
Yeah.
Dry me, I dessert. No time to have you lurking.
Just open a beer bottle with his teeth.
I had some buddies that could do that. Shout out Dalton.
Damn.
Nobody touched me in a righteous. Nobody text me in a crisis. I believed all of your dreams are duration. You took my heart, all my keys, and my passions. You took my heart, I must leave a decoration. Mistaken my love, I brought for you a foundation. All that I wanted from you was to give me.
Her voice is so like majestic. You know,
it's great, dude. What do you think about the floating little platforms?
Oh, bro, I kept telling Laura that like they could easily fall off.
Something
of that
could
thing,
happen.
Dude. Oh, easily.
Especially to one of the dancers that was like dancing on one of them.
Yeah,
because those guys they went as high as she did, but they were going up and down like the whole time.
Yeah, they got a lot of trust in those pulley systems,
It was pretty cool. My dad couldn't stop talking about it. He's like, why do they got? They got a cable from this side, or they got a cable from that side? He was pretty intrigued with it.
Would you do it?
Oh yeah,
I would do it too, bro. I would stay on there.
Especially at a Super Bowl.
Dude, did you know that she didn't make any money off the Super Bowl?
I saw that, and I didn't know if that was a lie or if that was like a thing.
It's real, bro. What was the...
I saw it on Instagram.
She didn't make any money from it.
Yeah.
But there was like 200... Or is it 20 billion? 200 billion?
What?
People that saw it.
Oh.
So like she's not getting a dime from it, but the exposure...
isn't it 200 million or something?
I think so. Let's see.
I thought it was like 283 million or something. People watching.
208 million.
Eight.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Wrong. I was wrong. That was not the most recent one. What is it?
Maybe they don't even have the stat yet.
Yeah. Either way.
Yeah.
It was like, it was damn near equivalent to the one last year.
Yeah. I mean, when you get a chance to perform at an event like that, like you almost kind of have to take it.
You're just like, let me just do it.
Yeah.
I don't need any money from it. Yeah. Everybody's watching.
Exactly.
And she hasn't performed, dude, in like
I thought it said 3 years. I thought I said read somewhere that it was 2 or 3 years.
Yeah, something like that.
This was her first live event back.
Yeah. Which means, dude, I think she's a billionaire.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, dude. I think she's a billionaire, dude. Is Rihanna a billionaire? Let's see. Is Riri?
So at that point, you don't need the money to do it. But I mean,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's a hard one, though, because then,
oh, yeah, she is.
Perform for free once, and it's like.
Yeah, she's a billionaire, bro.
Wow.
She was announced as the world's richest female musician.
Jesus.
Rihanna.
She's talented, though.
Oh, dude, super talented. But it also, like, you know, throw our entrepreneurship hats on, right?
Yeah.
She diversified her money very well.
Oh, for sure. She didn't make that money just in singing.
No, dude. She had, I mean, she owns like a, I think it's like a cosmetic company or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
Makeup company.
Yeah. I think she has like perfume too.
Yeah, dude. Probably like lingerie and stuff. Well. Dude, she diversified her stuff very well.
Smart girl.
Smart girl, man. Yeah. That's awesome, dude.
That is cool.
To be a billionaire. What else you got, Gary?
I think a lot of those people that they either go two ways. They buy a bunch of cool stuff, flashy stuff, or they invest that money into smart things like real estate. Or I'm not saying that's smart, but it has returned before. So
yeah, for sure. For sure.
Stuff like that. And they can either go up or down, basically.
Yeah, dude. I agree with that, bro.
I had on here, dude. You know how we talked in the last episode that I had that script?
Yeah, it was pretty close.
It was close for sure, but what's your take on that? Do you think that there's any funny business going on?
No, bro. I think the way that they played yesterday really made it like they were playing football, dude.
They were playing some pretty good football, but there was a few calls that was like, I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know, man. To me, I think after watching yesterday's Super Bowl, I feel like it's pretty like they're playing. You know what I'm saying? Like.
Yeah.
There's no, hey, like, intention to kneel down, you know, on this play, you know, whatever it is. Yeah.
Julian Edelman actually did an interview the other day and was talking about, like, they scripted me in 2007 to tear my ACL, so I was out for the rest of the season or something like that.
What?
But I need to go back and we need to watch the whole thing because I'm not sure if they're just pulling that out of context and he's, like, actually in a sarcastic moment.
What's his name?
Julian Edelman.
Edelman.
Uh-huh.
Whoa, what's going on here? No way, bro.
Yeah.
Is it this one?
I don't think so. It was on TikTok, but he was like on a podcast or like a news show that was chatting about scripted.
Seriously, dude?
Yeah, but that's what I say. I was like, I don't know if. I think it was out of context. I think he started off by saying like, oh yeah, it's scripted. In 2017, they scripted in there to tear my ACL.
Yeah, I don't think that's it.
But like, I think he's like saying.
Yeah, I get what you're saying, bro.
But no, we'll have to look into that. Maybe we'll get back to that on the next episode.
Damn, that's kind of crazy, actually. I mean, dude, anything is possible.
It really is.
Anything, and dude, the WWE is fake as fuck.
I think
love it.
Yeah.
So
it's
like,
completely like fake.
Yeah.
Like I think if it was anything with football, I think that there might just be little things to try to sway the game. But I don't think the whole game is played out like a play.
No, dude. And I have read some stuff where it says like certain teams want a losing record.
Yeah.
So like they can retain draft picks and stuff like that.
Oh, I see.
And then it becomes like. Instead of football being
strategic.
Instead of football being the actual business, right? Holding draft picks is the business.
Oh.
So like they'll never have a winning record. I hate to go back to the Browns, bro, but we're going back to the Browns.
Okay.
We went to the Browns on the last episode, right? I read somewhere that like the ex-head coach there before Baker Mayfield got there was saying like yeah, like they pretty much told him like, hey, you need to have like this winnings or like this many losses and this many wins so we can retain these draft picks, get these draft picks, and then we can trade them for a higher price than what we would have. Like it's like
a money game.
Yeah, it's like a stock game, but with the draft picks.
Oh, wow. That's interesting. I've never heard that take on it, but that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, it makes total sense, dude.
It
like,
really does. Wow.
Some of the like the Jets, bro.
Yeah,
the Jets are ass.
Yeah,
they've always been that way.
Yeah, but they've landed.
But they've landed like some first round picks because they suck so bad. And the theory is right that if you get a first round draft pick, your team eventually will be better.
Yeah.
They can come in and just like change the rhythm of your team, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Instead of doing that, let's get the first round draft pick, hype them up, trade them for more money.
Yeah, but does the team get the money?
Yeah, the team gets, I think they get a portion of.
Because if he signs like a 5-year contract.
Yeah.
And then they're supposed to pay him for that much, but then this other team.
They buy out his contract to get him.
And so that team's still paying him this much, but the team that bought him is paying over that amount.
Exactly, dude.
So they get the in between.
Yeah, the money triples, dude.
That's pretty interesting. I'll have to look into that, man. Yeah, I'm actually kind of intrigued now.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Huh.
I read that.
I can see that, too. Yeah, I mean, dude. It's just like sometimes you're like, how does this team not get out of its own way?
Dude, because think about it. There's so much money in the NFL.
Oh, dude. Obscene amounts.
So much money in the NFL.
Just looking at all the production value they had going into the Super Bowl. They had all these videos already filmed. I mean, so much.
Yeah, dude.
Giving away money. Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah, but the money's going to float through somewhere, you know?
Yes, sir. How much was it for a 30-second slot in the commercials?
Oh, I don't know.
Was it $7 million or something? I don't know how much it was. But
let's look it up. Cost of Super Bowl commercial. Let's see. It says the best and worst Super Bowl commercials or advertisers spent up to $7 million for every 30 seconds of airtime during the Super Bowl.
Ooh,
$7 million.
It's a big check, boy.
There's some people that won't ever reach $7 million in their bank account
ever,
and they're spending on 30 seconds.
If in their lifetime, they might not even make $7 million.
Bro, you know what that explains, though?
What?
How valuable time is.
Ooh, that's a really good. Yes, I like that. True.
Time is very valuable, dude.
It is, yeah.
You'll never,
especially in front of the correct eyes.
Yeah, dude, and you'll never get it back. Those people paid for 30 seconds of time.
Wow. Have you seen the movie seconds. Time? I think it's called Time.
Yeah, I think so.
With Justin Timberlake?
Yeah, yeah. Ooh, I think so, yeah.
Such a good movie.
Yeah, dude.
That's interesting, man.
Time is crazy, man.
It really is. Yeah, you think about it, you'll never do the thing that you just did, like, in that moment ever again.
No.
And it never goes that backwards.
You'll never.
I don't know why I'm going like that. That's not backwards. Yeah.
You'll never be able to go back, bro.
No. You got to just live it up. Watch it all pour out.
Live it up. Pour out. Yeah, dude. I don't know, bro. The concept of time is so crazy to me because, like, we, during the day, right?
Yeah.
We're going, obviously, through our work day. And you're kind of just doing it, right? You're not really thinking about anything outside of work.
Yep.
Right? I catch myself doing this all the time.
Yeah.
And the time where your brain actually clicks in to, like, for you to think about time.
Yeah.
Then you're like, whoa, I just spent 8 hours, like, just kind of, like, going through the motions.
Yep.
And then now you're out of work, right? And then you're like, damn, so now I only have this amount of time for me.
Yep.
Right? An hour, let's say an hour after work, you get off at 3:30, right?
Mm-hmm.
You need an hour to, like, shower and get dressed and do whatever you need to do before, if you got something planned.
Yeah.
Like, that's an hour to yourself.
Yep.
And then the whatever you're going to do, whatever's in your plan that day, takes up 2 hours, whatever. Now you're at, like, 10 o'clock.
Yeah, dude.
Your body's tired. You want to go to sleep.
And you wake up and do it again.
And do it again, bro. So you only literally get, like, an hour to focus on yourself.
Yeah.
I read somewhere that 40-hour work weeks weren't meant to last this long.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it was because of the World War. I think it was World War II. Something like that. It was either World War II. If that's the one I'm thinking of, it's where, like, the women really had to, like, step in.
Oh, okay.
Was that World War II?
Yeah, when all the guys were gone and, like, the industries and factories.
Yeah.
Didn't have any people.
I think that's the one it was, bro.
Yeah, it was.
Damn, I feel like an idiot if that wasn't the.
What's that, like, that there's a logo.
With the lady. Girl, right?
Yeah.
I
can't think of it.
Was it? I can't think of
the
it
The working, or what? Anyways, yeah, so.
Anyway. Let me see if I can.
Bro, the 40-hour work week just feels bad. Like, it sucks that when it's Monday. Like, why do we hate Mondays? We hate Mondays because it's the time we have to go back to work.
Yeah.
That should not be, dude.
No, yeah.
Like, you should just, every day should be a good one.
Yeah, it should be a good one. Let's see. Yeah, it was World War II, thank God. Okay, so I don't feel like I sound like a total idiot. But yeah, dude, they said it wasn't supposed to last up until like now.
Wow.
It's supposed to only last during that period.
What do you think it would have went to?
I think it would have went like...
like less days?
I think it would have been like... I think it would have been less days, more time, but you get more weekend time.
Okay, yeah. So like,
Monday.
4 10-hour days.
Yeah, or like, I don't know. I really don't know. I could probably look it up, but.
I have an interesting thought.
Yeah.
What do you think about a like schoolwork mentality to working?
What do you mean?
So instead of going to work from 8 to 5, you have to work then. It's more of a... like an assignment. So in college, right, you'd get an assignment and it'd be due in a week. What if the work schedule was structured like that, where it was, here's how much you have to get done. You get it done and there's no fuss. No matter if it took you 30 minutes to get it done or the whole entire week and it took you 100 hours to get it done.
But did you get paid the same?
Yeah, it's the exact same. And it's just this is what, like, the assignment you need to finish. Oop, I just touched the, this is the assignment you have to get finished. And, like that's your work.
Dude, I feel like more people would be, willing to do stuff faster, get it done faster.
And it rewards those that are better at their job. But then you also are on the flip side. You probably have to add checks and balances to that because people would skimp on the work too, right? They'd be like, it's done. It's badly done, but like you just needed it done. But I think that's a pretty interesting take because, oh man, I feel like a lot of people could really use that where it's not, you know, if they need to go to a doctor's appointment, right? It's not a big deal.
Yeah.
They don't have to take off work. They don't have to do all this stuff that's just, oh, today I won't start working until 10 because my appointment's at 8 or whatever. People might be a little more passionate about their job too.
I think they would too, bro.
Because then they could kind of, you know, if they needed to get it done at 8 o'clock at night, and they can do that if they had something going on the whole entire day, or I don't know. I think that's I know not every single thing could be like that. Like a factory couldn't do that because all the people have to probably be there at the same time. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
Facts. But for a lot of jobs, especially ones that went remote during COVID, I could see that happening.
For sure, dude. I'm not really, I'll have to dig into it, but
some of the most amount of work I did was when I was working from home.
Yeah. Yeah, dude. It's just, you're in your place. Like, this is your place,
comfortable.
Dude. It said it used to be a 6-day work week.
Oh, okay.
Has
Sunday always been the day off?
Yeah, Sunday's always been like God's day, right?
Yep, that makes sense.
So they actually brought it down to 5 days. And then like when the war really took off, the president during the time actually made it a mandatory. You had to work 48 hours. So you were still working Saturdays.
Dang.
Yeah. So like it went from mandatory. 6 to 5 to 6 again.
Wow.
Yeah. But they said pretty much it wasn't meant to last this long. Like, I think their explanation, if I remember right, was the fact of like 40 hours are only meant to be for one person. Like in the relationship, right? Whether it's the woman or the man.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
So then like you're like right now both people are working 40 hours a week.
Yeah. So it's 80 like, connected.
So it's what?
80 connected.
It's 80 connected, right? So like in those times, right? And I'm not getting like political or anything, but like the woman would stay home, right?
Yep.
And they had like all day to like do whatever tasks that they needed to do at the house or like go get groceries or take care of kids and all that kind of stuff, right? So the 40 hours are strictly supposed to only be for the person that was working.
I see.
Not for the household itself, right? So now you have a household that has 80 hours worth of time of being worked.
Yeah.
And there's stuff that's missing, the clothes are all over the place. Like, no one has time for anything.
Oh,
is what
I
I'm
see.
Getting at.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Both like, that person.
You both come home and like, okay, you have two kids. Like, you both got to take care of the kids. You both got to.
Yeah.
You got to take one parent's got to take the kid to like fucking soccer practice.
Yeah.
The other kids, the mom's got to take to the reading lessons or whatever it is.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And
I
like
get
the companies have capitalized on that.
Yeah.
That now everybody works 40
hours.
And
now it's just a normal thing. And if you don't work that, you're like underworking.
And you don't have enough money. You don't make enough.
Man, that's crazy.
Yeah, man.
I just remember, man, going to work. Oh, it's like when you wake up, or even at night sometimes, it would drift all the way into the nighttime. I would get sad because I know that I have to wake up and go to the job.
For sure.
God, dude. That's
the Sunday scaries, dude, and the Monday mornings.
Yeah, and then like when you're there, you said you kind of forget that you're just wasting time. When I was there, that's all I could think about was the fact that I am stuck here and my time is worth more.
Bro, you can't, if you leave,
yeah,
right? Unless you have a very valid excuse,
yeah,
you have to be there in order to pay your bills.
Yeah.
How crazy is that, man?
Sucks. And I remember like sometimes check to check almost where it's like, dude,
yeah,
come on. You just waiting for that payday, but you just worked like the whole entire time.
Dude, you busted your ass too. Yeah. Dude. Yeah. And then someone can dictate how much your time is worth.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's crazy to me. Yeah. Yeah. It's nuts, bro.
Yeah. I'm very glad that. I still work, but I don't work that typical.
No, it's different.
I love not doing that because that was my biggest.
It's different, bro.
It made your passion of like, even if you liked what you were doing, it still just made it not. Yeah. I don't think I could have a normal, like, even if I was working what I'm working now, but it was that type of structure,
mm-hmm.
whereas you had to be here at this time for like these days constantly every single day or whatever it is.
Yeah.
I don't know if I could even do that.
No. Not anymore. You've seen the other side of it, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And kind of getting to pick your... Oh, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've went off on that too much, but
no, you're
that
good,
was
bro.
A good one.
You're good. You're leading it right now because I don't have a dang thing written down.
Oh, it's all me.
Yeah, I don't have anything written
down.
Dang,
28's my episode, huh?
Yeah, I couldn't find anything today, team. So we're just riding on Gary's coattails right now.
Bro, I'm telling you right now, I'm getting hungry.
So am I, dude.
We should figure out what we're going to eat.
Starving.
Okay, so I was swiping on social media the other day. And I saw this little thing about speed, right? You know, speed from YouTube, Twitch, all that stuff.
Oh, no. When you said speed, I was thinking of the drug.
Oh, no. Speed, you don't know who Speed?
No, I know I know who he is. Oh, okay. I immediately thought, like, drugs for some reason. I don't know why.
So, I don't even know how to get into this, but so usually in a relationship, right, like, sometimes one of the parents isn't as supportive as the other one is.
In the relationship?
No, like towards you as a kid.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so,
yeah, for sure.
So, like, your mom is really supportive, but your dad is kind of like, get a job, blah, 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 that type of stuff.
Yeah, for sure.
For Speed, I saw this video. It was actually kind of the opposite for him, which is kind of a weird dynamic because if it's the opposite of most people, you probably feel like it's actually you that's messed up, right?
Explain it to me.
So, here's the thing with Speed. His mom was like really, there was a lot of videos where she would barge in and be like, turn that stuff off, like get a job.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. And then there was one video where he called his mom on his birthday and she was like declining him and all that stuff. Right. And for most people, it's the dad that's like, I don't know, for most men anyways, I should say.
The dad's an ass.
The dad's the one that's not the supportive one. Your mom is like,
supportive one. Yeah.
You know, always going to be your mom.
For sure.
And this one was kind of the opposite for him. His dad was like the really supportive one.
Oh.
And maybe that's just a me and you thing, but yeah, I feel like for the population, it's usually that way if the parents aren't, if one of the parents isn't supportive.
For sure, for sure.
And for this one, his mom was the one that was like not supportive.
Yeah.
So how weird would that be though? Because everybody's like, yeah, my dad's not supportive. Like, yeah, my dad, but my mom loves me. And he's like, what do you guys mean? Like, my mom doesn't, but my dad does. Like, is that weird? Am I actually doing the wrong type of thing?
Yeah.
But this is kind of just like a motivation thing, but he kept going. Obviously, he's really, really popular
now.
But isn't that kind of weird to think about? How hard would that be for a person?
Bro, knowing, and the thing is too, is like we both know how our moms are already.
Yeah.
We've experienced like them, right?
Yeah, and they're kind of feel like that's for everybody.
They're being. Mm-hmm. And
they're kind.
If I, like knowing how my mom is now.
Yep.
And experiencing her,
mm-hmm.
to have her not be that way,
mm-hmm.
dude, that would suck.
Yeah.
That would hurt.
Yeah. And also, I'm not saying that either of our dads are not supportive.
No, they're very much.
I was trying to paint a picture.
I feel like both our families are very supportive of what we do.
100%. Especially some of the dumb stuff I
do. Yeah. But like, dude, that would suck.
It would, yeah.
Because that's your mom, man. Like,
yeah.
Your dad's your dad, but I feel like it always crisscrosses, right? Like, a lot of the time, the men, like, they call them mama's boys, right?
Yeah, yep.
But that's your mom. Like, that's your first, like, love.
Yeah.
Like, real love, right, that you feel as a boy, as mm-hmm. a man.
nurturing,
yeah, dude. Yeah, and like dude. Your dad's your dad, but like he's like rough on you. He's usually the
kind of
he's usually the enforcer, right?
Yeah.
In hypothetical, like what we're talking about, right?
The stereotypical.
Stereotypical. He's the enforcer. So it would be weird to just like not have a connection with your mom.
Yeah, I saw it today, and I didn't think it much of it, and then I started thinking about it. Like, man, that would kind of be a weird situation,
dude. Whoa, that was a little aggressive there.
Starting a boat.
But dude, there's people that experience that every day.
Yeah, yeah.
Like in real life.
And then they go into the world and they don't even
they don't know what's different, dude. I was having a conversation with one of my coworkers the other day,
mm-hmm.
and like, she's got like this like heartbeat. I don't want to say deficiency, but like
I know what it is. It's like skips.
Yeah.
Yes.
And she's like, Jesse, like I've never thought twice about my heart ever. Like yeah. I went through the military. I went through a fire academy.
Can't think of it.
Like, no, she didn't know about it.
Oh.
Is what I'm saying.
Oh.
She never second guessed it.
Oh, okay.
She just thought that the way that her heart was like
that's
beating
how
was
beats.
Normal.
Oh.
So then I started thinking to myself and I'm like, how, like, am I not feeling the stuff that people are feeling?
Dude, I do this all the time.
And I'm not trying to put my tinfoil hat on or anything, guys, for you guys that are listening or watching, but it is a real thing. Like,
it is. What
dang, like, do I take a breath and it's the same way that you take a breath? Like, you feel the same thing? And then think about people with asthma.
Yeah.
People that have asthma that have never gone to the doctor and don't know, like, they just think that's how they breathe.
That's how everybody breathes.
Yeah.
Yes. Dude.
How crazy is that, bro?
I know. But I'm almost on the reverse spectrum of that. Sarah has like some back pain every once in a while.
Yeah.
And I've just never dealt or like even cramps. I don't think I've ever had a cramp.
In your leg or anywhere?
Anywhere, dude.
Really?
Yeah. And maybe
I've had cramps before.
Maybe I've felt that thing, but I just didn't know that's what
it was.
Felt like. Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
It's so weird. So my story was, I feel like I'm on the opposite. I'm not very good at empathizing with like somebody that has foot pain or headaches
really
or migraines because I haven't.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
It's crazy, bro.
That is really crazy.
Yeah, man. It's crazy.
I like that. Gosh.
Should we do a little Jesse Was Poppin' to split it up?
Jesse.
What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? Mm. This week, we're going to rip it off with Morgan Wallen, Last Night. It was just released 13 days ago. Because without privacy,
couple weeks.
Damn, 13 days ago and it's already got 2.2 million views. Fuck. Anyway, it's off of his new album. Like I mentioned before, you're now tuned into Morgan Wallen, Last Night. Let's get it.
Last night we let the liquor talk. I can't remember everything we said, but we said it all. You told me that you wish I was somebody you never met. But baby, something's telling me this ain't over yet. No way it was I last night. I kissed your lips, make you grip the sheets with your fingertips. Last bottle of Jack, we split a fifth. Just talking about life, going sip for sip. Yeah, you know you love to fight. And I say shit I don't mean, but I'm still gonna wake up on you and me. I know that last night we let the liquor talk. I can't remember everything we said, but we said it all. You told me that you wish I was somebody you never met. But baby, something's telling me this ain't over yet. No way it was our last night.
Last night liquor talk.
No way it was our last night.
This ain't about to be a little Uzi. Well,
it was
the
last night we break up. I see your taillights in the dust. You call your mama, I call your bluff. In the middle of the night, pull it right back up. Yeah, my friends say let her go. Your friends say what the hell. I wouldn't trade your kind of love for nothing else. Oh baby, last night we let the liquor talk. I can't remember everything we said, but we said it all. You told me that you wish I was somebody you never met. But baby, something's telling me this ain't over yet. No way it was our last night. We said we had enough. I can't remember everything we said.
Just on, bro.
We said too much.
I dude, if you really listen to the lyrics, bro. Yep. That is a toxic ass relationship.
Oh, for sure.
And I've been in some toxic ass relationships.
Yeah.
But I've never been in a toxic ass relationship where I said, this ain't over.
Oh, you were like, nah, you're not gonna be.
I'd be like, it's over. Get out.
Yeah.
That's how I am. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
I've never been in that relationship to be like, no, the fuck, we're not. We're not over. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
You ain't going. That doesn't make any sense. You're not going anywhere.
No. Especially if one person's over it, it's like, yeah, just.
Yeah. Psst. No, it's over, dude. Once that one person makes their mind up,
yeah,
it's over.
Mm-hmm.
It's a goner, bro.
For sure.
But yeah, dude, never been in a relationship like that
before. I didn't listen to it that good, but I'll have to go back and check that out. You got anything else, dude?
Yeah, dude. I'm gonna do the ambition footage. I wanna watch the video. Oh. Let's see. That's number one with vets. Your vet we let the liquor talk. And her own and dog. Plus, its delicious beef flavor is number one with dogs. Use with caution. That sounds just like him, huh? Of seizures
yeah, or dude. Neurologic
disorders. Ask your vet all right, about this NexGard. Episode is brought to you by NexGard. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye. This next song on the Jesse Was Poppin' playlist is playlist segment is Key Glock Ambition for This Cash.
I didn't catch it at first.
This is a good song, dude. Never seen the video, though. What are we at for time?
Bruh, like 40 minutes.
We can keep this one short.
For sure. No, I was asking. I was going to go to another topic.
Oh, that's what I was asking. Okay. Sorry. Cool. All right. Well, let's. Damn. These intros, man. I'm telling
They're
you.
Getting
man.
You, dude.
Take heat. Fuck these niggas up. Is that a box Chevy? What is that? Oh, it is a Chevy.
Glizak.
Glizak. Yeah. Bitch, I'm in my bag. Yeah.
I just made a bag.
Yeah.
Bag a big bag. Yeah, nigga, I got a
real ambition for this cash.
Yeah, nigga. I got a real ambition for this cash. Yeah, 13 years old
with a shoebox stash.
Yeah, I'm always up to something.
Never sitting on my ass.
Nigga, this Glizak, I got my skinny sag. Nigga, I told that Glizak with a passion. Nigga, I told that Glizak with a passion.
I have no idea.
And I talk a whole lot of shit cause I can bag it. Bitch, my heart cold. My last name Moncler. My pocket's fat swole. No, I don't eat pearls. Ain't trapping, ain't dead. These niggas just queer. I'm sipping color purple syrup. Ballin' hard just like the beer. Yeah, and Larry Bird. I'm shooting shit, I know you heard. 10 toes never in no.
He's got that deep Memphis accent. Here, how do you say it?
What's up? Hey, I pray but don't go to church. Don't ask me to spit a verse. Can't trust no hoe, that's devil word. Yeah, I know the devil word. And I know that nobody's perfect. Still can't trust a bitch for certain. For real though. Yeah,
bitch, I'm in my bag.
Oh.
Anyway, that was Key Glock Ambition for This Cash, Gary.
Heck yeah, I don't even know if I've ever seen Key Glock before.
Yeah, Key Glock, he's really good. He's dropping an album soon.
Ooh.
I think this week, maybe?
All right.
Friday?
We'll have to let him know.
I'll bump into that on the way home.
Yes.
What's your next topic, bro?
Oh, I was going to say something about that shirt you got on.
Oh, well, what is it?
I was going to say we wanted to just say thanks to everybody that showed up the other day.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, guys.
That was dope.
For everybody that showed up to the photo shoot.
Yeah, man.
It
was really fun.
Word on the street is everybody had a blast.
Good.
Yeah, word
Good
on the deal. Street, everybody had a
it
blast.
It was a blast. For me, anyways.
Yeah, dude, we definitely have to do another one.
Oh, yeah.
We got to design a new one.
Yeah.
And did I ask you if you had Adobe Illustrator? You have that?
Yeah.
Is it a computer program or is it an iPad program?
It's like you can have it on your iPad, but it's like a Photoshop, Premiere. It's the same thing as those.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Apparently, so that's where the guy who printed them out and stuff?
Yeah.
That's what he uses.
Yeah, I use that a lot for like promotional like posters or anything like that.
Yeah, dude. So maybe we could use that and sit down and try to. I almost said what our next design was gonna be.
Oh, don't do it.
I'm not gonna do it. But stay tuned. We're gonna be dropping some merch.
Yes.
Maybe not this month, but maybe next month. We're gonna design it.
It's the 13th already.
Yeah.
It's getting later in the month.
Yeah, it is actually. Shoot. What else you got, Gary?
I think that's it. Yeah, I just wanted to thank everybody for showing up and making it a fun time, putting up with our butts for a while.
On a Saturday, it was really chilly when we
got
out there.
It was cold, dude. God, I'm about to go to Texas here soon. It's freaking cold there. It's like 50 degrees on the middle of the day.
Dang.
It's freaking warmer here than it is there.
Dang.
I don't know about for a while, but
let's just end it on this one.
Ooh.
Let's see if it'll play. These damn. All right, this song is brought to you by Peacock. You know when
someone's lying. Hey, right before we do this, what was your favorite Super Bowl commercial?
Hate each other.
I'm not trying to be like religious or anything, but the Jesus one was really cool.
Yeah, that was cool.
Where it was like all like black, like it
people
starts
yelling
off
at each other.
Yeah, yeah, I thought that one was really dope.
Yeah,
they did have a good Doritos commercial. It was with Jack Harlow. Remember he was playing the triangle thing?
The triangle.
Besides that, dude, they didn't really have like very good ones.
Was there even a Budweiser one?
No, there wasn't a Budweiser one.
No. I didn't like a lot. Honestly, this might be controversial. A lot of them I thought were kind of cringy, dude.
Yeah, they weren't very good.
A lot of like singy ones and just, I don't even know. They were using so many actors.
Yeah.
So many actors.
Yeah, they just weren't very good.
Yeah, I did like to watch that little segment where they were talking about the Nike shoes.
Oh yeah, dude,
that's
a good movie.
Kind of cool. Yeah, I want to see that. I haven't seen that.
I want to see it.
Yeah,
yeah, that'll be sick
for sure. But I think that is it for me, dude.
All right. Well, I
just a quick little Super Bowl recap.
Yeah, I don't have anything written down, so we're just gonna end it off with Black Bear Chateau. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for listening. We will be back with another one soon, so stay tuned.
Yeah, yeah. Sweet 23 at the chateau. Had a hard man, I'm trying to get it back, dawg. Trying to get it back, trying to get it back, trying to get it back. Age 25 and I'm rich now. No excuse, you'll be acting like a bitch now. I gave you dime in the pool, write the checklist. She want a ring, ain't fucking with a necklace. I'm a fool for these things with the big butts. Take a homebody, turn her to a rich slut.
I like where
feel
the beat
like
drops
I can't
too.
Trust nobody, even day ones. Watch out for them snake ones. Sweet Benty today at the chateau. Had a heart, man, I'm trying to get it back, girl. Wait, 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 ghost, let's go. Please, baby, please, baby, talk slow, talk slow. I'm off the blow, I'm off the draw, I'm in my zone. Grab your girls, grab your phone, and let's go. Get ready, we go into the chateau. Legs around my neck, I got your nails up in my bag. Get ready, we go into the chateau. No love, no love, no love, no love. Just fucking in a California cave.
Anything else, Gary?
I think that's it, bud.
Right.